Our first task is to manually download the data we need in this case study. The NCBI is the National Center for Biotechnology Information, and it is the United States' main public repository of DNA and related information. We will download two files from the NCBI. The first is a strand of DNA, and the second is the corresponding protein sequence of amino acids translated from this DNA. First, we want to enter the website of the NCBI. You can either go there directly, or you can Google NCBI. In this case, it's the first hit that comes up. Now you'll see at the top where it says All Databases, we're interested in downloading a nucleotide sequence. So we scroll down until we get nucleotide. And in this field, we need to enter a specific code that corresponds to the sample that we want to download. Here, you need to be careful to type in exactly the following: capital N, capital M, underscore, 207618.2. Once you have entered this exact string, you can hit search. If you did your search correctly, you should see the same page that we have here up on the computer. This page contains a lot of information about this specific sample. We're primarily interested first in the DNA sequence. The DNA sequence is shown at the bottom of the page, but the best way to download these data is the following. You can go to the very top of the page. You can click FASTA. And then you have the sequence here on the screen. You can then use your mouse and your cursor to highlight the sequence. Make sure you include the very first letter, which is G, and the very last letter, which is T. We can copy that, and then we go to our spider editor. I'd like to create a new file here, so I just click New File. I then delete whatever happens to be on the screen. And the next step is to paste the DNA sequence into the editor. The next step for us is to save this DNA sequence. I have previously created a directory that I've called Python Case Studies. I first go there. This case study is the translation case study, so I will be selecting that folder. I want to call this file dna.txt, and I recommend you use that same file name convention. I then have to choose a .txt in the menu here because we're saving a text file, not a Python file. And if all goes well, you should now have dna.txt in your Python case studies directory. Let's then go back from our sequence page to the main page for the sample. And to download the amino acid sequence, you can click CDS. CDS stands for the coding sequence. If you look at the bottom right corner of your screen, you will see the translation here at the bottom of the pop-up window. I'm going to select that. Then I'll go back to my Python editor. I'll open a new file. I'll remove whatever is in this file. And then I will paste the amino acid sequence into the editor. I will then go to save. I will then pick my previously created Python case studies directory. I go to translation, and I'm going to call this file protein.txt. Again, it's a text file, so I need to make sure I choose text file in the menu. And now we have downloaded both the DNA sequence and the protein sequence file.